Good afternoon. Gosh, what a crowd. What a great group. This is the biggest place we could find, and obviously not quite big enough for everybody. You've probably heard about the show, and it's really more of a production. Before we get into that production, though, I want, with any size group like this, you're going to have a couple people that have to be introduced. And we do have a couple of our officers with us this afternoon. I'd like to ask them to stand if they would. First, from our Communications and Computer Services, our Vice President Lee Mitchell. And a gentleman that is certainly no stranger to you, he's our division head, our Vice President of Customer Service, Mr. Bruce Nobles. For many of us in this room, we've been through three mergers. And then 6 months ago, when Northwest and Republic announced the merger, there were a lot of us at Republic that were as surprised and dazed. And in that 6 month period of time, just about weekly, we've been meeting with our counterparts, working to make sure that once we do get the go ahead, which we expect any day now, that we can make a smooth transition for our employees. One of the things that I learned during this 6 month period is that we have some very effective communicators at Northwest. What you're going to see today is nothing less than spectacular. It is a team of 68 members of Northwest and Republic in-flight service, selected from the Flight Attendant Corps, working with in-flight service management to put together a presentation that you're really, truly going to enjoy. A gentleman that is responsible for the communication program at Northwest, and in particular in in-flight service, is a gentleman whom I've only known for 6 months. But I can tell you one thing, the type of presentation you're going to see today is the type of leadership that he directs at Northwest in-flight service. Brent Baskfield began his career at Northwest approximately 10 years ago. He was selected to manage their public relations program. 4 years later, a very successful program manager, he was promoted to vice president, and for 3 years served in that capacity. For almost 3 years now, he has served as Vice President of In-Flight Services for Northwest. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming Mr. Brent Baskfield, Vice President.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. I'm overwhelmed to see this kind of interest and kind of pride in your performance and interest in your future. Can I have the house lights up a little bit so that we can, I can see you and then you can see me? Can I ask one question, maybe a couple questions? Number one, who's just a little bit nervous about this merger? Any hands at all? Everybody else feel very confident? Anybody over here just a little nervous about the merger? So am I. So am I, and so are all Northwest flight attendants. So is everybody at Northwest, just a little bit nervous about the merger. Are you nervous because you think Northwest flight attendants are going to take your illegal overnights? Huh? Or your trash 10 flights? Trash 10 flights? They can have the trash 10 flights? No, no. Northwest flight attendants are nervous because they think you want the 8-day trips to Tokyo and Shanghai and Manila. They can have those. You see, I see that it's all going to stay about the same. We're going to bid our own schedules, and it's just that the buffet table has increased in size a little bit. We're all going to find something that meets our appetites and pleases our appetites. So even though we're nervous about the illegal overnights and the trash 10 flights, I think that it's going to work out just fine. Let me tell you a little bit about the history of Northwest Airlines. 60-year-old company, founded here in Minneapolis, St. Paul, down at Holman Field. The first passenger was supposed to be the mayor of St. Paul. The young mayor of St. Paul decided that his political career was too promising to get on this rented open cockpit biplane for that first flight to Chicago. The first flight was 9 hours. It was 1926, 9 hours, four stops, two unscheduled in hayfields. We've come a long way. We've come a long way. When you join Northwest Airlines, and you're going to, you're going to join a rich tradition of history, rich in character and rich in flavor. Did you know that Charles Lindbergh worked for Northwest Airlines? He and Amelia Earhart helped pioneer the new routes over the mountains to Seattle from Minneapolis. The Mayo brothers at the Mayo Clinic helped our engineers and our pilots design and innovate the first oxygen mask, which we gave to the airline industry. We have 60 years of service in Minneapolis, St. Paul. So we pioneered service to the Orient. This is our 40th year in the Orient. We've got a lot of competition and we need your help. We pioneered service to Europe, North America, throughout North America, and also the Pacific, and really designed this new polar route, which was new back 40 years ago, the fastest way to Tokyo. We're back into China, Shanghai. We serve Shanghai, China. So we've got a lot going for us, but we need your help. You know, I kind of feel like the bridegroom before the wedding. I'm just a little nervous. Some of you who raised your hands are too. But you've had more experience at the altar than I've had. the marriage isn't a one-sided romance at all. We need you, and you need us. It's kind of nice to come to in a relationship like that. We need your mass. We need your feed. We need your professionalism. And you need our strength and our security and our professionalism. Let me tell you a little bit about the history of this uniform, which is kind of unique. It's unique in the fact that we went to the designers, uniform designers and other designers, and said, 2 years ago, we're looking for a new uniform. You know, we've had this uniform now for 7 or 8 years. We need a new one. We gave the designers a copy of the history of Northwest Airlines, asked them to read it, and then asked them for 6 months to fly Northwest Airlines worldwide, and then to come back to us with a new design. Three of them came back. Three of them came back. Three out of four came back and designed us new uniforms. And we had a new uniform presentation in New York, Chicago, Minneapolis, Seattle, and Tokyo. And we had a fashion show, much like today, a fashion show for all of our flight attendants. And we asked for their input on the new uniform. Tell us what you like, tell us what you don't like. We're going to make this uniform so that it enhances and underscores your professionalism and our world-class airline. And I don't think you're going to be disappointed today. You know, we're proud of our team, and that's what it is. It's a team. We're proud of our performance, proud of our professionalism, and proud of our people. It's kind of tough to be professional when the ice chest won't pull out of your galley. It's kind of tough to be professional when there's no brakes on your trolleys. It's kind of tough to be professional when you consistently run out of meals. And we've got some programs that we think we can help eliminate most of those problems. You people, there isn't a soul on this earth, and much less Minneapolis or St. Paul or Northwest or Republic, who doesn't want to do a good job and doesn't want to like his or her company. But sometimes the managers, the directors, even the vice presidents get in the way. I'm going to promise you one thing, and that's all I'm going to promise you. I promise you that I'm out to get you. And if you don't believe me, ask Rocky, your bus driver. Because Rocky knows everything, right? I'm out to get you. I'm out to get you everything you need to do the job professionally. And that's all we can expect of each other. Everything we need to do the job professionally. Together, we're going to outserve every other carrier. Let me tell you, Northwest Airlines right now is almost at 3 commendations for every 1 complaint. We're second only in the complaint commendation ratio to Delta Airlines, which is quite an achievement. With your help, we'll be number 1. No question about it. With your help, we'll be number 1. You know, someone once said that the world isn't changed by the great shoves of one hero. It's changed by the consistent pushes of every honest employee or every honest worker. And I'm really looking forward to pushing with you, working together for that secure future. I have news. The Minneapolis base will not shrink in size under the new Northwest Airlines organization. We're going to stay about the same. We're going to look into a new DC-9 base in Seattle. I have more news. We're going to hire between 300 and 500 flight attendants between now and the first of the year. What do you think of that? And I have one more piece of news. We're going to have first-class China service on all 727, 757, and every DC-9 that will accommodate it. And we're going to do everything in our power to provide this kind of professional service that you all want to provide. So I'm out to get you. Your professional staff is out to get you. And I'm just delighted to be here with you today as this kind of a first date with us and before the merger and the marriage is announced. So we're going to have fun today. You're going to see an incredible show. And again, I want to thank you for taking time out of your busy schedule to come here to witness a little bit about what you're going to be a part of in maybe a week or two. Thank you very much. I'm proud to present to you your co-anchors for today's show. First of all, Ms. Trish Wills, who is your director of flight attendant service, and our director of in-flight service, Mr. Lloyd Warren. Ladies and gentlemen, take it away. Thank you very much.
Trish and I are also pleased to welcome you and anxious to get the show on the road. Now, before we do that, we would like to take you on a trip down memory lane, showing you the history of Northwest and Republic Airline uniforms. I can think of no better way to start that journey than to introduce you to the first stewardess ever employed by Northwest Airlines. She began her career based in Chicago in 1939. Ladies and gentlemen, Mrs. Virginia Beck.
Research and preparation for this production indicates that the first flight attendant for any of the predecessor airlines of Republic was Wade Brown in 1951 at Wisconsin Central. Regrettably, Wade is deceased and therefore unable to be with us to share this special recognition, but many Republic employees of long standing have fond remembrances of him and his Jackie Gleason type appearance.
And now forward to the past. 1939 began the stewardess era at Northwest Airlines. The 40s, Northwest Airlines introduces the DC-3. There is one stewardess for every 21 passengers. In the mid-40s, the DC-4 and Martin 202 were added to the fleet. Minneapolis had 2 airports, one in St. Paul at Holman Field, the other one, Wool Chamberlain Airport, Minneapolis. We had non-stop flights between Minneapolis and St. Paul. 1947, the purser entered the picture. Northwest Airlines began Pacific flying.
Don't you wish Mitch could loosen up a little bit?
Renee Foss is modeling the peach uniform, which was worn in the late 30s and early 40s. Laura Kiefer is modeling the blue uniform worn from 1940 to 1945.
He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. He was the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
And yes, it's Mick Barron's wearing the purser uniform.
And when he plays, he makes the company jump a to the bar. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. Do 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 da da do da da do do. He blows it a to the bar. He can't blow a note if the bass and guitar isn't with us. The company jumps when he plays reveille. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B.
The 50s. Joining the fleet in the 50s was the DC-7 and the Stratocruiser. Everyone loved this airplane. It held 81 passengers. It was the first four-engine pressurized airplane, had a telephone and an organ on board. In-flight entertainment.
DC-3s and F-27s were the aircraft of this decade for Republic's predecessors. Wisconsin Central became North Central in 1952, and females replaced the male steward at North Central in 1954.
Come fly with me, let's float down to Peru. In
the light blue, briny marlin uniform worn in 1950 is modeled by flight attendant Susan Ostris.
Come fly with me, let's take off in the blue. Once I get you up there.
The first North Central steward's uniform was worn in 1951 and is being modeled by Randy Larson, Minneapolis flight attendants. The stewards were constantly being confused with the pilots since the uniforms were so similar.
Up there, I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer.
1953 brought the first designer uniform designed by Tina Lesser. You see the summer black check version worn by Delise Price Neeland. Delise is also featured on the front cover of our brochure that you received.
Southern Airways chose a navy wool gabardine suit to attire their flight attendants in 1952. And Grimsby, Detroit flight attendant, certainly does justice to this ensemble.
And the Navy winter version of the Tina Lesser design is modeled by Tamara Holter.
Once I get you up there, where the air is rarefied, we'll just glide.
Detroit flight attendant Sam Bowers is shown in the first North Central female stewardess uniform of teal wool gabardine. The year was 1954.
I'll be holding you so near. You may hear angels cheer, 'cause we're together.
Shay Smith Johnson is modeling the Taylor Brooks blue winter version of the 1958 to 1963 uniform.
It's perfect for a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly.
This smartly tailored knit uniform worn by Leslie Cacapardo, Memphis flight attendant, was a favorite at North Central in 1957.
Oh, and this has memories. David Nelson is modeling my purser blue dinner jacket. And David, you too will gain weight, I promise.
And we'll beat the birds down to our
Lloyd, it looks like it fits him better than it ever fits you.
Yeah, it does.
For a flying honeymoon, they say. Come fly with me, let's fly, let's fly.
up, let's fly away.
The 60s. The 60s found us entering the jet age. The 60s also brought the miniskirt. The Northwest Airline fleet consisted of Electras, DC-8s, 707s, 720s, and 727s.
At North Central, Convair 340s, 440s, and 580s were used for Super Northliner flights. Southern used DC-3s and Aristocrats to serve 61 cities in the South. The first DC-9s joined the fleets of North Central, Southern, and West Coast in 1966 and 67. Air West was born in 1968, merging West Coast, Pacific, and Bonanza Airlines.
Kai Doring is modeling the White Purser dinner jacket.
This 1961 North Central uniform of light brown wool gabardine is worn by Tracy Jackson, Detroit flight attendant.
Mary Jo Balder is modeling the brown Northwest Airline uniform worn from 1963 through 1967.
In 1961, Southern chose this turquoise dress ensemble with Navy accessories for its flight attendants. Bobby Hernandez, Memphis flight attendant, seems right at home in this one.
The winter blue version of Northwest Airline uniform worn from 1963 to 1967 is worn by Simeon Scott.
Bonnie Butler, Memphis flight attendant, is modeling the Southern 1964 Aqua Dacron and Wool Ensemble. The beret made its debut, replacing the standard hat.
Dottie Peterson is wearing the Northwest Airline famous green uniform, worn from 1968 to 1970, more commonly known as the Caterpillar. Kim Marine is wearing the red, white, and blue winter version of this uniform.
Dream about the days to come when I won't have to leave alone. About the time.
In the mid-60s, Bonanza flight attendants wore this black and white combination so nicely modeled by Jolanda Robinson Moore from the Minneapolis base. Some of you remember this next one. Pacific's uniform of that era was this bright hot pink ensemble worn by Karen Tenter, Minneapolis flight attendant. Teddy bears and blankets were sported by the flight attendants in response to a comfort and safety ad campaign by the airline. The West Coast uniform at that time was a chic black tailored ensemble worn by Minneapolis flight attendant Lisa Ouellette. In 1966, North Central introduced this Paris designer uniform by Courage, worn by Darlene Searle, Minneapolis flight attendant. Southern had this coral A-line dress and jacket combination designed in Paris. This was very popular with the flight attendants in 1967 and is being modeled by Memphis flight attendant Gail Simmons. And last but by no means certainly least, the first Air West uniform, 1978, being modeled by Malia Day, Minneapolis flight attendant.
The 70s. May 1970, the Jumbo 747 jet arrived. The DC-10 was added in 1973. 1979, Northwest Airlines entered the European market.
In 1970, Air West was bought by Howard Hughes and became Hughes Air West. More DC-9s joined the fleets of North Central, Southern, and Hughes Air West. Stewards returned to the ranks at North Central and were hired for the first time at Southern and Hughes Air West. Deregulation brought many changes, and in 1979, North Central and Southern merged to form Republic Airlines.
Wearing the winter version of the Northwest Airline uniform, worn from 1970 to 1972, is flight attendant Ann Wicks.
North Central began the 70s with this Apollo blue dress ensemble with striped coat, modeled by Memphis flight attendant Ann Perron.
And wearing the summer version of this very short Northwest-oriented uniform, worn from 1970 through 1972, is Mary Janz.
In 1971, Southern provided an array of choices for the flight attendants, including the outfit worn here. Also worn were silver tunics, black pajama pants, and black hot pants. Memphis flight attendant Donna Monroe carries this one off well.
The uniforms changed in 1972 to the summer version you see worn by Colleen Featherstone.
Air West had corporate designer Zamparelli create an array of items for its flight attendants in 1971, dubbed as the Sundance uniform. Sylvia Townley Peeler, Minneapolis flight attendant, is modeling her own uniform.
The winter version of the Northwest Airline uniform of 1972 with the geometric blouse is modeled by Kim Kistner.
In 1973, North Central offered its male flight attendants a winter and summer choice. Detroit flight attendant Ray Rolak is modeling the winter version, and Detroit flight attendant Quentin Quackenbush sports the summer model. In 1973, North Central chose this navy and white houndstooth combination being worn by Minneapolis flight attendant Susan Nelson. In 1975, Southern took a very different approach with this Eisenhower jacket and walking short ensemble. Fortunately, Memphis flight attendant Diane Armstrong looks great in knee socks. North Central put their male flight attendants in this chocolate brown three-piece suit in 1977, worn by Detroit flight attendant Daniel Lason. Dan still fits into his own uniform. The female version of the 1977 North Central uniform is being modeled by Detroit flight attendant Julie Kibbe. In 1978, Southern offered a paisley blue and beige combination being modeled by Joyce Baker, Detroit flight attendant. Finally, in 1978, Hughes Air West took a more conservative approach with a beige military look for both men and women, being modeled by Minneapolis flight attendants John Tronis and Mary Brady.
The